The real interesting question is how many other people had no idea that this was the allegations in this case may actually be borne out to be true. That everything that AmTrust did here was geared towards saving themselves money at the expense of all of these claimants and taxpayers who are now going to fund the deficiency. All of these other people are out there. They just don't know it. They don't know that their cases were settled for a fraction of what they're worth based on the fact that a conservancy and a liquidation was going to happen and their plaintiff lawyers really had no choice but to give in. We are not going to give in. We're going to see this through to the end, which is what I said, all the way through and find out exactly why they did what they did. And we really know what the answer is. It's obvious. They had 5 million reasons to do what they did to IDIPRUS. How many other people are out there that they did something similar to that just don't know it?
Were actually asked by the judge flat out, do you see this as a potential class action? And you said, absolutely. 100%.
But the class that's out there doesn't know it. They don't know who they are yet. How would they know? We're going to open this up, and then people are going to see what really happened here. And then you're going to see that a lot of other people are going to come forward and say, wow, what happened to me wasn't right either. They may not have been defrauded directly. In other words, promised a sum of money and then not given that. We may be unique in that sense. But all of these other claimants were paid fractions of the money that they may have been entitled to based on the fact that they couldn't face up to the challenge of this liquidation and the massive amount of lawyers that could be thrown up and the stacks and stacks of legal papers that could be put in front of your face. I don't care about that. I care about getting this lady what she's due and finding out what happened and getting to the bottom of it. And we will.